Schnabel!
Thank you.
truck today. Just flat.
Oh, did you?
I landed right beside the curb. But it was a pretty good one.
I'm like so scared like of my back doing that.
During the day, I've had a cup of beer, like a tall can. Went to the LC over here, went over, had a tall can.
Yeah.
This is the worst, like,
over there.
Yeah, thank you so much. What a great
view. Oh, dude. I would do anything to avoid this little spot.
We literally went up Bronx, you were like, I don't know, what do you want to eat? Like, I don't know, do you want to have this? We biked all the way up Bronx, turned around and biked all the way down Sorora, like, all the way back. And then came down here past everything, like, oh, there's that place, oh, there's this place. We ended up at Alexandria Falafel. By that time, I was so hungry, I was like, I don't fucking care. I want to have it now. I want to eat something right now.
That's how it started. It's like street food, right?
Yeah, totally. I barely got any on.
Gave me the wrong pin code. Oh, good, that's okay. Yeah, this guy's still all through.
like, they're walking down the street. And yeah, he just like takes a selfie stick, snaps it in half.
They're like walking in front of him. He's like, they're like in their way. They're like, here, let me help you.
Like tips down a row of like rental scooters.
we have to make a point to watch with Jess an episode of Seinfeld once a week at least.
Yeah, I'm down.
That's a commitment. So I can get all the fucking jokes. Like, everything ends up, this episode of Seinfeld.
But my work,
you're like, oh, is it the weekend right now? I'm not sure.
No, no, that is for real, though. Like, yeah, my job, like, the weekend is in the middle.
It was, like, a little bit.
You
were on that show, like, yeah.
My friend Jordan, he, like, last year, he, like, made this, this documentary, but it was about the stupidest thing ever. It's like, he... taking this, like, this, like, exercise bike, you know, from the 90s or something on the side of the road, picked it up, and then they decided they didn't want it, and then they, like, threw it in the forest, and then they decided to bury it in the backyard, and he's renting, dude, from our friend, so it, they had already filmed a bunch of this, and he had decided to make, like, this documentary about burying this bike, this elliptical bike, in the backyard, in secret.
Deep hole, and then, for the antics of it.
Exactly.
And then made a full documentary. He does this, like, he went to school to make documentaries, and he has made documentaries, like, real ones. So it's professionally done documentary about them not wanting to go to the dump, really. Like, with them being too cheap to go to the dump. And he didn't tell anybody what it was about, and he was like, I'm having this premiere for my movie I'm making, it's called Body Shop. No one knew what it was. We were all like, oh, it's gonna be a skate park, it's gonna be like a mountain bike park. You see, like, mountain bikes a bit, and thought it would be funny, like, that, and something that he would do, and then it turns into be this, like, documentary with a very nice electrical bike in the backyard. And then, because of that, and we got, like, he got, like, 20 people or so to go.
It was huge. It was really great, the way it was done, and how far they took this buried bike, and how far it went.
He's interviewing people, and he's got all this, like, phone footage.
Not to mention where they buried it in their friend's backyard.
Yeah.
There was a fence put over top of it because they had dogs, so they put a fence in, the fence went over top of it, and the seasons had changed, and, like, plants were, like,
and it had almost, on top it of had it. Almost gotten found by, like, Grace's mom was, like, doing some planting in the same spot, and they had footage of her gardening out there, like, right in the same zone and stuff. And then, anyway, he was like, he was like, what if we did this every year and everybody made a little, like, project thing, so.
Fucking
yeah, like we all watched it, and then we went in the backyard and visited the spot where it was buried, you know? And he even had, like...
see, like, the top of the seat.
Yeah, he had, like, a stone. I think someone had, like, dropped off that stone. It was, I don't know, it was, like, this weird little grave.
It's like rap. It's like rap. There's like New England.
What's like rap? Did you say grap?
Said it's like rap.
Have you ever had a grapple though?
Oh, I have had a grapple. I totally have had a grapple.
Right?
It's insane, dude. It's like
an apple that tastes like a grape.
It's like not only grape,
it's
but like
a grape the
fruit.
Size
it's
of an apple.
Oh, I don't know. I don't like fucking like genetic.
No, totally. It's like injected.
Is it cucumber? That was just in The Simpsons, man.
No, that's legit. The tomato. They all exist.
They're real, but we made them.
Pretty good smokes, eh?
That's
I like this dog.
Yeah.
It's, that's why, like, eating American South was, like, perfect for it, which I'm sure is, like,
the same. She's small but sturdy.
Longitude, oh, maybe turkey would be.
She's not dainty.
You're not my dog, but you are.
Yeah,
no, that's interesting.
I think
that'd be a great
stepdad. Yeah, he got that from the States.
Camel
in the States. Used to just be Virginia, but then they had a lineup called like Camel Turkish, and it was like Camel Turkish Silver, Gold, Royals, and that was the half domestic, half Turkish flip. What's interesting to me is that this is a Camel Red, just like the basic, and it has that claim. So maybe something's changed up, and that's just the recipe now.
I love the tree in
there. Dude, great tree. Raccoons fucking love it too.
Yeah, there's a couple of messed up there. I climbed it once.
Yeah?
I had a beer up there once.
Like, coming down looks harder than getting up there.
Oh, dude, it was tough getting down. Our address is confused with the hospital address.
For, like Uber?
It's a bully, like, yeah, with balloons and shit, like, full gift baskets and shit. And then I go over there. I'm not sure if this is, like, every hospital or whatever, but... There's no concierge or anything. I walk in, I'm like, I have this thing.
There's no maitre d' over there.
And I've walked around with packages like, I don't know. Well, I've just like dropped it off at a door.
I'm
like,
I know, right? It's gonna find its way, hopefully. I'm just gonna drop this on the floor.
Yeah. It's better than me just taking it inside and pulling it apart and eating all the juicy fruits or whatever.
The juicy fruits.
You know, it's crazy.
No, if it's a hospital, it's got to be Juvenile.
Pass Peel, there's a big warehouse, and I've been to a few parties there now, and, like, sometimes they're, like, 500 to 1,000 people, and then, like, but then there's a big room, and we went to a big room, like, maybe, like, 2,500 people.
It was fucking huge.
It's like, I need to meet you here at this time.
No, fucking that's watch. Gone now.
Did you ever see Maestro Fresh West? Or Scratch Bastard?
Like, yeah, dude. Maestro is coming to fucking Fest.
Yeah,
that's crazy.
Yeah, that's wild, yeah. They're just like parties. It's like a party, you know? There's like a DJ set up and whatever, you know? There's a homie rolling up here.
There we go.
Cedar Aurelius. I'll bomb the hill past your house.
Do you think I could get in on maybe one of those wristbands?
Oh, you can stay over, Mark.
What am I going to do during the day if I don't get in?
Jess is like, I kept all the wristbands from last year, and I think the same colors will...
Yeah, I got a bunch from a lot of years.
Well, that's what you were saying. It's like, it even looks like the one from last year.
Made some fake ones 1 year. Yeah. We're in our friends.
Subaru, like, writing and all that. Yeah.
Like, how close do they look at them? Yeah.
They don't. They're a bunch of volunteers. Yeah.
It's like they look at it hard the first day. It's like the it's Friday night would be hard, but like... Yeah. I swear Sunday you could just walk in there.
Yeah, for real. Yeah, who's coming?
Band of Horses?
Band of Horses. Like, that's who I want to see. Yeah. Like, yeah.
Bruce Coburn's going to be there.
Oh, Bruce Coburn?
We just said, Tesla!
Tesla, baby!
The first text he's ever sent me, I got his number, like, fucking years ago. When he moved to Massachusetts, he was like, oh yeah, but apparently, like, my backyard, the hill in my backyard is, like, the local, all the local kids, like, coming, like, toboggan down.
Toboggan down, yeah.
And he was asking me about, like, little jumps and stuff, and I really meant to, like, go up there and
check it out.
Take a look at it. It sounds sick. Like, Travis Schilling parties.
That checks out, yeah. Kind of like respected.
Yeah, respected people that are cool.
Yeah.
Party.
That party.
Yeah, drugs are not exclusive.
Doctors.
Yeah, drugs are not exclusive. Yeah.
Doctors party.
Oh my god.
Nurses. Doctors.
Fuck.
They
nurses
party.
Fuck.
They fuck.
I kind of want to get some other cigarettes.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to smoke those. It's even gross.
Well, that's why, like, you gotta get the blues. Yeah, like, the red is full stuff. The blue is the lights.
what about galleons and guns? New World. Just skipping. Montezuma. Beautiful and strong. Dancing across the waterbound. It's the best one. I need to find that. I need to be able to reference what that actually is. What performance that was.
That song from Rust Never Sleeps. Is that
Rust Never Sleeps? We need to watch that. When we go aside, Rust Never Sleeps.
He's wearing like all white and he's got suspenders on.
Came a dancing across the waterbound. Give me a little powder finger. With a big red beacon, a flag and old man on the rail. I think you better call John, cause it don't look like they're here to deliver the mail. It's just a mile away, and I hope they didn't come to stay. Got a gun on the side and I'm gonna make it big ways. One of the first times I remember like Dylan was like he became like a friend of mine. I had done like a farmer's market in Aurelia. It was like I moved home and I had made all these like wood crafts and like sold a bunch of cactus and I grew a bunch.
You were doing greens.
I was doing like a farmer's market thing, right? And I had like some I carved out some spoons and some whatever, some cutting boards and shit, and sold some cactus. And there was a guy playing at the farmer's market. He did like a cover of Powderfinger. That song, and I was like, I got a fucking way better version of that, dude. Fuck that guy. That guy sucks.
That was the inspiration.
Yeah. And then Dylan's like, yeah, dude, fuck that guy. That guy sucks. I was like, yeah, dude, let's do a way better version of this. Powderfinger. You need to keep clips of Blood Out too.